Well, it looks like a man went overboard from a Catalina ferry. This was just before 6 p.m. yesterday, 3 miles off the coast of Long Beach. Multiple boats and a dive team were assigned to search for the guy. People saw him go over the side. They don't know if he jumped or fell off the boat. But they say that's a first.
That's weird. Well, it's weird that that's a first.
Yeah.
I mean, the number of people that go back and forth on that thing, I'm surprised that it hasn't happened before.
It's just that guy and Natalie Wood.
Passengers recalled seeing him before departing. One woman said the man was with his girlfriend. Most of the passengers got off the boat in Long Beach and immediately boarded another boat to continue their journey to Catalina. Well, still bubbling up is this fight between the L.A. County Sheriff, Alex Villanueva, and people on the boardwalk in Venice. These actions by the L.A. County Sheriff have angered some, not all, in fact, I would say not most, of the people who live and pay for life in Venice. But as he was walking down the boardwalk, there were people shouting at Sheriff Villanueva.
How many people?
Well, I mean, if you watched the TV coverage last night, they made it look like it was a couple hundred. It was probably three,
yeah,
or six. And some of them were giant a-holes about this whole thing, saying, "You talk on Instagram, but you're an effing a-hole, and you'll talk to us now." First of all, you're yelling at the guy. He's more likely to shoot you than he is to talk to you when you're being a jerk to him.
When people are not able to go out of their homes after dark, the sheriff and the police agencies have a duty to go in and figure out what the hell is going on.
Yeah, and that's not to say that everybody who lives in a tent in Venice is a horrible person.
No.
There are people that they're trying to help. There are people there that perhaps don't get the services that they need, and maybe the sheriff's department is the doorway by which they turn their lives around. But just saying that, you know, that they're going through and, you know, sweeping everybody out of there, which is not what's happening, you look like a moron.
All right, I have two public service announcements. The first one is, don't buy your Botox out of somebody's house.
Excellent life lesson.
The second one is, don't sell counterfeit Botox out of your house.
What goes into counterfeit Botox?
I don't want to know.
No, I don't either.
But it's stuff apparently that could cause infections, facial paralysis, tissue death, and blindness.
Can I add an addendum to your life lesson?
Yes, please.
Don't get butt implants at a Motel 6.
Unless you're in the panhandle of Florida. I've heard that those are actually reputable.
No.
But no?
No.
I wouldn't.
There goes my summer vacation.
The Jazz beat the Clippers again.
Man.
It's not good, guys.
There was one point in that game they were tied at 101. And I thought, hey, there is a chance the Clippers, oh my gosh, what's happening? And they missed like 9 shots in a row.
Yes.
It was unbelievable.
Donovan Mitchell was the star, 37 points on the night as the Jazz take the 2-0 lead in the Western Conference semifinals.
Full house last night in Salt Lake City to watch that game. Full house. And they didn't do a lot of close-up crowd shots. But the ones that they did, it looked like masking was at about 10%.
The Donovan Mitchell, by the way, first Jazz player with at least 35 points in back-to-back playoff games since Karl Malone in 1988.
I was just going to say, there's got to be a John Stockton or Karl Malone number in there somewhere.
I remember their last series together. I think it was against the Kings.
Would have been in the mid-90s?
Yeah, no.
Late 90s?
Early 2000s, I think.
Oh.
Anyway.
Mookie Betts hit his 25. Alex does this on purpose. Alex does this on purpose, doesn't she?
Yes. Because we are living in Los Angeles.
Okay.
Not San Francisco.
Relax. Mookie Betts hit his 25th leadoff home run in his big league career. Dodgers kept their dominance of the Pittsburgh Pirates. They swept them last night with a 6-3 win.
Just one game behind the Giants. I mean, granted, the Padres are one game behind the Giants, too, but still. Just saying.
The San Francisco Giants?
Yeah.
I didn't know that. They don't own the best record in base. Yes, they do, as a matter of fact. That's weird. Huh. I wasn't really paying attention. The Dodgers host the Texas Rangers tonight. The Angels, meanwhile, are in Arizona to take on the Diamondbacks.
John Stockton, Carl Malone.
Yes.
Their last series together was 2003 with the Utah Jazz.
Good job, Shannon.
Yep. Felt good. Felt good nailing that one down.
Good to be right on that.
Good to get a 25-year-old or 18-year-old reference nailed down.
Gary Shannon will continue in for Handle. An update on the news. Jennifer Jones Lee.
The Biden administration is no longer sending money to farmers based on race. A judge put that on hold because of a lawsuit from 12 farmers who claim the loan forgiveness program is unconstitutional and should be available to white farmers as well. Anti-Semitism is rising across the country. The surge came after last month's 11-day war between Israel and Palestine. And a New York street is now named in honor of Marvel comic book legend Stan Lee. It's called Stan Lee Way. The 95-year-old died in 2018. He's the mastermind behind some of the greatest superheroes featured in comic books and movies. We've got a look at your ride on the 10 with EKFI in the sky next.
Hey, if you want to sell your house or condo fast and easy, call Seller's Advantage to buy your home as is for cash. With Seller's Advantage, there are no realtor fees or commissions, no escrow fees, no repairs needed, no open houses, no strangers walking through your home. They buy your house or condo for cash. David and Doug from Seller's Advantage just bought a house from one of our KFI listeners. The owner wanted to sell the house. He met with a couple of real estate agents, and then he met with Seller's Advantage. He compared the numbers. Well, he went with Seller's Advantage. Smart KFI listener. He ended up with the same money, same bottom line, and no repairs, no headaches, no open houses, no hassle. He says working with Seller's Advantage was the easiest real estate transaction he has ever completed. If you're considering selling your home, call Seller's Advantage and see how much your home is worth. VRE number 01961658. Call now for your free quote. Call 888-321-AS-IS. Call 888-321-AS-IS. That's 888-321-AS-IS. Or go to sellersadvantage.com.
Mix up your routine with plant-based alternatives at Whole Foods Market. Get 25% off select Kite Hill plant-based products through June 15th, plus an extra 10% off for Prime members while supplies last. Learn more on the Whole Foods Market app.
SoCal weather from KFI, sunny today with highs lower 70s to the upper 80s. This report is brought to you by Whole Foods Market. Let's check out this crash on the 10.
This was in Claremont on the 10 westbound just before town. The two middle traffic lanes going to be taken away from your drive. So volume starting to mount to ride around Monte Vista. KFI in the Sky is sponsored by injury attorney Superwoman Superlawyer.com. Jeff Vaughn, update downtown Los Angeles.
Yeah, another section of the 10. Now, we're headed back to recheck this, but when we left, this is a bad problem. It was westbound Santa Monica Freeway leaving the East LA interchange at Alameda. That's only two exits over. Most of the freeway was shut down, three left block, two right open, and the backups were really building quickly. Now, as promised, we went out to industry for a look at the 60. The 60 westbound is still good before it really stops at 710. That's a long way going over to the West End and Alameda, and also back up. As a matter of fact, everything that comes into the East LA interchange that leads you to the West End, the Santa Monica Freeway, is all backed up. But West 60 and the South 5 all backed up. The rest of the West End now coming in from the 605 through the 710 all the way to Boyle Heights and the I-5. That at least is looking pretty good. More on the Santa Monica Freeway coming up. Internet and accident, visit Superwoman, Superlawyer.com. Jeff Baugh, KFI in the Sky.
On the 210 westbound before Azusa Avenue in Azusa, stalled tanker truck still blocking the third lane from the left. Expect that delay at 57. KFI in the Sky helps get you there faster. I'm Robin Banks.
This report is sponsored by Rocket Mortgage. Get personalized loan options, closing costs, and tax estimates all in real time. When you need your mortgage to fit your family and budget, Rocket can. When you want the ability to adjust your loan options in real time, Rocket can. Rocket Mortgage.
Hey, you've heard all these commercials about great home loan rates, But maybe you've thought, I'd love to get one of those, but I bet I don't qualify. Or maybe somebody's just flat out told you, nope, you can't get that low rate. Well, that's because you haven't called the people at IntelliLoan. They have got you covered. Right now, IntelliLoan has a 1.99% rate in APR with no points or lender fees for SoCal residents, and this is even if you have a credit score as low as 620. This is a 1.99% rate in APR with no points or no lender fees. How do they do it? You have to call IntelliLoan and ask. Daryl, the owner of IntelliLoan, he wants to talk to you. And when you guys are going through your negotiations and you're doing your deal, he'll give you his email. He'll give you his cell phone number. He wants to make sure this process is as simple as it can be for you. So call IntelliLoan today and ask about a 1.99% rate in APR with no points or no lender fees. Call 1-800-918-6200. That's 1-800-918-6200. Or just go to IntelliLoan.com.
Rates subject to change without notice. Minimum loan amount requirements apply. 60% loan to value and 620 FICO credit score. Certain restrictions apply. Subject to credit approval. NMLS 3290. Loans made or arranged pursuant to a California Finance Lenders Law License number 6036970. Equal housing lender. IntelliLoan. Borrow smart.
Have you been putting off life insurance for a while? With the long application process, medical exams, and blood tests, it's no wonder you put it off. It can seem so confusing, expensive, and time-consuming. But Ethos is a new way to buy life insurance. Ethos is built with you in mind. Instead of a medical exam, you only have to answer a few health questions. Our application is 100% online and can be done in about 10 minutes. You might even get same-day coverage. At Ethos, we match you with the right policy and the right price from top-rated carriers, with no medical exams and no blood tests. Now you can spend less time sorting through confusing paperwork and more time with the loved ones you want to protect. Go to ethoslife.com today to apply in minutes. That's ethoslife.com. Ethos Technologies, Inc. operates in some states as Ethos Life Insurance Services. Not available in all states.
An important message from Kaiser Permanente. Thanks to new federal funding, you may be among the millions of Americans now eligible for federal financial assistance to help lower your health coverage premiums, even if you didn't qualify before. That's right. You may now qualify for federal financial assistance to help lower your health coverage premiums, even if you didn't qualify before.
Call Kaiser Permanente now at 1-800-494-6261. That's 1-800-494-6261.
Get sizzling solar savings now with Semper Solaris, your local veteran-owned solar and battery storage contractor. Being veteran-owned matters. Here's veteran, founder, and owner Kelly Shawhan.
In the military, when you give your word, it just is your word. Work hard and keep your word. That's what we do every single day. Everybody did exactly what they said they were going to do, and that really impressed me. I've heard about Semper Solaris and found out that they were veterans, so I knew they were going to do the job right.
Declare your energy independence. Choose solar panels made in America. We get the job done right with esprit de corps and honor. Add Tesla Powerwall and prepare for blackouts. Grab the federal 26% solar and battery tax credit. No interest or payments until 2022. Call 877-211-5591. 877-211-5591. Or visit SemperSolaris.com.
26% federal tax credit based on eligibility. Consult your tax advisor. Cannot be combined with any other offers. All approved credit. New customers only. Some restrictions apply. Expires 6/30/2021. CSLP number 978152.
Want to know the secret to making sure everything at Ralph's is fresh? Secret Shoppers. Guys, we hire to expertly inspect our produce department in every store. Their mission is to ensure we have the freshest bananas, lettuce, and more. Now that the secret is out, you know what else is? Tomatoes that are fresher than fresh. Ralph's. Fresh for everyone.
Now it's even easier to save on your favorites with delivery and free pickup. Just visit Ralph's.com or the app today. Restrictions apply. Ralph's. Fresh for everyone.
It is time to embrace all these names.
These terms.
I'm a NIMBY.
I'll shatter from the rooftop. Not in my backyard.
I don't want to live with meth addicts. Period.
Not across the street, not next door, not within 10 miles of them.
You have every right to a nice neighborhood. You don't have to feel guilty about it. You don't have to explain it. You don't have to defend it.
John and Ken.
We paid it too.
You earned it. It's yours.
On KFI.
You're perfect then. I want you then. Can I get down? I like the way you work it.
No biggie.
I thought you'd bag it up. I like the way you work it.
It's Black Street? Is that what it is? What's the name of the band?
Yeah.
I don't know if they did or not.
think that was before their time, actually. Gary and Shannon, KFI AM 640 live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app. Some of the first meetings of the G7 summit have been taking place there. The world leaders gathered around a big round table in St. Carbis. The place where they are. Anyway.
Robert Durst is back at it. He's being treated in a jail hospital, so jurors are going home for the week. Of course, he's accused of killing a friend back in Benedict Canyon 2 decades ago. Prosecutors are questioning whether he is really ill. Deputy DA John Lewin saying that he's been heard on jail phone calls, saying he plans to fake dementia or other illness to secure a mistrial. That checks out. That's on brand.
Sounds about right. The first fully vaccinated cruise from North America. Repeat that. Everybody on that ship is fully vaccinated. Had 2 people test positive for the COVID.
I also have other COVID news.
The celebrity Millennium is now docked in Curacao. Passengers who tested positive are still in isolation. Obviously, they're asymptomatic. Obviously, they're not going to give it to anybody else. But.
Do you know about the Delta strain from India? How they've been trying to terrify us with headlines like gangrene, hearing loss,
testicular pain, dry eyes.
Apparently, this strain has been in LA County since April.
Oh.
And the number of cases detected has been very low.
Oh.
But Ferrer says it should still be a warning that the threat is still out there, lurking.
Wasn't it lurking in April?
Waiting to give you gangrene. Yes, it was lurking.
And dry eyes.
But we continue with Handle on the News.
All right, we were talking about baseball a second ago, and there's a Padres fan whose catch of a foul ball has gone viral. Why? Because Lexi Whitmore snagged a foul ball with her bare hands. Oh, by the way, what'd she have in the other hand? Her 3-month-old son, Maverick.
Yeah, what did Maverick have in his hand? A 16-ounce Bud Light. She said, here, honey.
Hold
my beer.
I love it.
And then she caught, and it wasn't, no, not to take away from it, still great reactions, but she didn't catch a home run ball out of the air. I mean, she caught it after.
Explain this to us.
I gave her all the credit in the world. Are you kidding? The reason she says she's...
Don't take away from her in her moment.
Hey, we don't deserve moms, do we?
No, right? We don't.
Okay,
that was an excellent bow on that story.
In fact, the Padres called her Super Mom.
That's
well,
very
I don't
nice.
Know about that.
Well, she's there by herself and her baby. That's good.
All right. It looks like there is a viral TikTok showing a groom checking his phone while a bride walks down the aisle.
Look at the
This reminds me a little bit of what happened with CeeDee Lamb during the draft when he had a couple phones. And Cowboys were calling, and his girlfriend picks up his phone, and he snatches it right out of her hand. Like,
You don't know. Be careful what you wish for.
Huh? What was this guy checking as his bride walked down the aisle, huh?
Well, in the video captioned Husband of the Year, the girl, the woman, the wife, wrote, 4 years ago today, I walked down the aisle to marry the love of my life, one of the most important and emotional moments of our life, and my husband did the most romantic thing.
He checked his freaking phone.
And the picture is from back in the, you know, the behind everybody, and you can see him up in the front. And he pulls his phone out of his front pocket and looks at it. Now, there's a couple of people come to his defense. Some of them have said maybe he had his vows on his phone. By the way, don't do that. Write them out. I'm just saying that as a professional wedding officiant.
Yeah, I put him on an index card.
But other people, I guess the new video shows, babe, TikTok wants to know why you were checking your phone while I was walking down the aisle, says Lauren to her husband. And her husband turns to the video and says, because crypto never sleeps.
That wasn't a thing 4 years ago. I would just say I was putting it on silent. That's what I would have said. Well,
I was checking this for the game. Or
yeah, I almost had the 49ers. The 49ers were playing, I believe.
Exhibition.
The week, yeah, the weekend of my wedding, and I almost had it arranged for there to be screens showing the game if I was going to get married.
Here's the thing that wouldn't have been out of character. Nobody would have been like, why is?
No, I actually had a 49er helmet on the top of my wedding cake.
That's a true story.
That's awesome.
God, who does that? Why did I do that?
I wore a Braves garter.
Okay, that makes me feel better. You're making me feel better.
I didn't do any of those things. My wife, though, she saw the picture of you wearing the giant Dodger bobblehead yesterday. Uh-huh. She wants to know if you know how to use a lice comb.
Ew.
When we come back.
Petros doesn't have lice.
Was he the one wearing it?
I don't know.
LA Unified and the Teachers Union have come to an agreement to, finger quotes, fully reopen classrooms. You need to pull your child out of LA Unified, and I'll tell you why when we come back to the Bill Handel Show.
We're not here to tell you what to think.
We're here to give you the latest.
KFI.
KOST HD2.
Los Angeles, Orange County.
Live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app.
Challenging an ending. I'm Jennifer Jones Lee, live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. Governor Newsom has called out opponents of gun safety reforms while announcing an appeal of a federal judge's decision that ends California's assault weapons ban.
For folks that wax on about public safety, and they sit back passively and say nothing about this outrageous decision, shame on them. What frauds they are.
Newsom says Judge Robert Benitez, who is a wholly owned subsidiary of the gun lobby, according to Newsom. California's asking for the ban to remain in place during the appeals process. A bill that was shut down a decades-long running gun show at the OC Fair has been called political theater.
There are no illegal activities taking place.
Crossroads of the West gun show owner Bob Templeton says the bill violates the Second Amendment and freedom of assembly and eliminates jobs and millions in tax revenue.
He's attempting to close access to California state-owned property.
Senator Dave Mann of Irvine says everything is not legal at these gun shows.
Even if there were zero illegal or ghost gun or unlicensed transactions, I think there's a moral principle at work here, given just the overwhelming levels of gun violence that we're seeing in our country.
The bill is now being heard by the Assembly in Orange County. Corbin Carson, KFI News.
The Union for Teachers in the LA School District has reached a tentative agreement for a return to traditional in-person learning for school next year. The proposed deal includes standards for continued COVID-19 testing and mask wearing. Gary and Shannon are going to talk more about this passionately, I think, in just a moment. An Asian American man has been attacked at a park in Cerritos. Cesar Echano tells NBC4 he has nightmares and is scared and anxious.
I don't want to go out anymore.
Echano says a young white man punched him in the face last week at a park and cussed him out. Echano's eye got busted up and he was bleeding from his face. He says he still has headaches and double vision.
Please stop the hate.
The Biden administration has agreed to restore nearly $1 billion in funding for California's bullet train. In 2008, voters approved nearly $10 billion in bond money to build a high-speed rail line between LA and San Francisco. In 2019, the Trump administration cut funding for the project. The gunman who killed 9 of his workmates at a rail yard in San Jose last month reportedly had been investigated 4 times for his workplace conduct. The Mercury News says after one argument the guy had with a co-worker, that colleague said he was worried the guy would go postal. The G7 summit officially gets underway today in Cornwall, England. ABC's Karen Travers says President Biden will sit down for the first time in person with a group of world leaders.
The president and the G7 leaders are focusing on the global economy, climate change, and investing in infrastructure around the world. Tonight, a royal welcome.
Tonight, Queen Elizabeth, Prince Charles, Prince William, and the Duchess of Cambridge, Kate Middleton, will host a reception for the president and world leaders. Well, laughing gas could be just what the doctor ordered to help people dealing with depression.
Nitrous oxide is a chemical typically used to sedate people having medical and dental procedures. But researchers at Washington University in St. Louis say breathing the gas in small doses could help with severe depression. A study published in Science Translational Medicine says the gas helps improve symptoms in patients who said antidepressants didn't work. The lead author of the study says laughing gas may offer certain advantages over other drugs and treatments because it's already in every hospital and it has less serious side effects. Deborah Mark, KFI News.
And a couple of condos in San Francisco with a tie to Humphrey Bogart are on the market for a little less than $8 million. The two penthouses take up the whole fourth floor of a building which was featured in the 1947 film Dark Passage, which starred Bogart and his wife at the time, Lauren Bacall. We're watching your stall on the 14.
It's going to be an accident. It's on the 14th southbound before Sierra Highway. You'll see that stalled car in the carpool lane. Looking at some slow traffic right around Crown Valley Road. KFI in the Sky is sponsored by injury attorney Superwoman Superlawyer.com. Jeff Baugh, clearing downtown Los Angeles.
Indeed, good morning. I come with good news. Now, there was quite a problem westbound on the Santa Monica Freeway at Alameda, just leaving the East LA interchange. They blocked most of the freeway there for a long time, but all lanes have been reopened. Now, we still have some leftover slowing, and quite a bit of it, actually. Anything around the East LA interchange really complicates a lot of freeways. So the slowest right now is the West 60 coming away from the 710, even North 5. That's due to another problem, too, up around 4th Street. More on that coming up. But South 5, North 5, all of that going out to the West End. Now, the West End volume going out towards Culver City, West LA, all that, is starting to build now, but at least we got all lanes open again. We came down to 710. I was looking for some issues. I'm happy to tell you nothing. If you're leaving Long Beach, pretty easy drive. Southbound's a little slow, getting around the 105 down towards the 91, but not too bad. We'll have the Golden State Freeway coming up. Injured in an accident, visit superwomansuperlawyer.com. Jeff Baugh, KFI in the Sky.
Clear directing Claremont on the 10 westbound before town. Out of the two middle traffic lanes over to the shoulder, you're still going to find some slowing, though, right around the mountain. KFI in the Sky helps get you there faster. I'm Robin Banks.
Hey, it's Dean Sharp. Summer is here, and as the weather gets warmer, we all start reaching for more water. But instead of plastic bottles, how about just fill your favorite glass with filtered water from any tap in your house? With a Light Source Whole House Water System, every faucet flows with clean, delicious water. No maintenance, no filters to replace, no tanks to exchange. And if you have hard water, they can help with that too. Light Source removes the odor and taste of chlorine without using salt or chemicals. Your hair, your skin will thank you for bathing them in filtered water. So have LightSource create a customized water solution for your home, direct from the factory that has served Southern California for over 37 years. Everything is U.S. made with installation and support for the life of the system. And if you're looking for a great new career opportunity, LightSource is looking for you. Call LightSource today for full service and full confidence in your water. 800-334-5009. 800-334-5009 or visit LightSourceWater.com. LightSource Water. Taste and feel the difference.
Hey, California, did you hear about the Big Vaccine Incentives Program? You Call the Shot California gives $50 incentive cards for things like groceries or shopping at your favorite small business to the next 2 million Californians who begin and complete their vaccination against COVID-19. Make that vaccine appointment today at myturn.ca.gov or call 833-422-4255. Give vax for the win, people. It's a win-win for you and California. Vaccinated Californians ages 12 and up are eligible. Visit COVID-19.ca.gov to learn more.
Your KFI Financial Report is brought to you by Bay Alarm. The Dow is up 48, S&P gaining 5, NASDAQ up 20, gold is $18.83 an ounce, and oil is $70.58 a barrel.
The KFI Money Report is brought to you by Bay Alarm, now offering virtual security consultations using your mobile phone. Visit bayalarm.com to get protected today.
SoCal weather from KFI. Highs today will be around 80. Inland will be in the low 70s at the beaches. But those inland temperatures are just going to keep going up over the weekend. We'll be in the 90s and triple digits by next week. Right now it's 60 in Santa Ana and in Glendora, 57 in Pacific Palisades. We lead local, live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. I'm Jennifer Jones Lee.
Step by step, ooh baby, gonna get to you, girl.
Gary Shannon.
Step by step.
KFI AM 640 live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app. I don't know if you guys saw this, but unemployment was a gigantic deal over these last 16 months or so because of all of the industries that had to be shut down. People lost their jobs. According to the CEO of a company that provides fraud prevention services, ID.me, the CEO says of the billions of dollars that went out in unemployment relief, as much as $400 billion of it may have been stolen. Cash funneled to criminals in Russia, China, and Nigeria. Now that's including all of the, you know, as much as 11 or 15 or even 20 billion unemployment that came out of, that was stolen from the state of California. Leaders of the G7 industrialized nations going to commit at their summit today to share at least a billion coronavirus shots with some of the struggling countries around the world. Half of those will come from the United States. UK also announced 100 million vaccines.
UTLA and LA Unified have reached a tentative agreement to fully reopen classrooms for 2021-2022. Again, this is for this fall when, what are we at, 70%, something of that nature? Oh, that's, yeah.
In terms of vaccinations?
Everyone's vaccinated.
Many
people are vaccinated.
The vast majority of people who want to be have been.
Yes.
And those who don't want to or for some reason can't have not yet, obviously. I want to point to, okay, so this deal between the teachers union and LA Unified was announced yesterday. They say it's a tentative agreement, of course.
They say it's about safety, right? About COVID. The testing, the screening, ventilation, cleaning, disinfecting, even though, again, it's the fall of 2021. We're not wiping down our counters with bleach anymore.
Right, because we've shown that's not an effective way to fight this thing. But they continue
surfaces
to want to do
this. Surfaces are not a thing.
That's not how it happens.
No, and we learned that months ago.
So the side letter that was published yesterday, was released in the media, shows this between LAUSD and UTLA for the return to traditional instruction. By the way, if you're wearing a mask and you're an 8-year-old, there's nothing traditional about that. But right away, Section 1A, what does it say in there? Section 1A, what's the first thing it says?
LA County is in the yellow tier.
Time out. What's wrong with that?
We're not going to be in the yellow tier in the fall.
We're not going to be in the yellow tier in the fall.
We keep the pace. We are moving now beyond the blueprint.
What? You mean?
We are announcing today that on June 15th.
That's just a couple days away.
We will be moving beyond the blueprint.
Yes.
And we'll be getting rid of the colored tiers.
Thank God.
Now, they do say the district will conduct COVID-19 testing every 2 weeks while in the yellow tier. So once we move out of the yellow tier, maybe that testing goes by the wayside.
The tier goes away in 4 days.
This isn't about safety, though, guys. This is about money. This is about getting money down the line already, and you've got to go through 8 pages of safety, scheduling, blah, 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 blah. Oh, here's the money. The training rates are going to double for teachers, and all teachers will get a stipend in recognition of the additional work required to teach a combination class of students, because they're going to try to combine classes. And then, you betcha, they have an agreement when the contract is up that there's going to be a pay increase. And what they're going to say is the teachers worked tirelessly during the pandemic to make sure your kids are still up to date.
And here's the thing.
And I'm not saying teachers don't work hard and that it hasn't been a situation. Some teachers, I know they've had to teach 3 different versions of the class, in-person, virtual, combination. I get that. But don't make it like this is about safety and not about money. We're not dumb.
There's something so weird about living in this microcosm that is LA County. I know it's a giant county, and I know there's a lot of people here. But there are places in this county that have been in school in person since October.
Yes.
Full day, no masks, and there are no outbreaks. There are no temperature screenings going into school because those have been ineffective. There have been absolutely no outbreaks in these schools. In Northern California, even, there are schools that have been in session, in person, since January. And if this is, this should be an indicator, this should be a wake-up call to anybody whose kids are supposed to be in school in the fall.
It's not about the kids.
It's not about your kids. They don't give two rats' asses about your kids.
This is about the next contract for teachers. This is about them pointing to all the things that they had to do. We had to do testing. We had to do health screenings. We had to wear masks at work. We had to wipe down the classrooms. We deserve more money. You didn't have to do any of that. None of that had to be done.
Right.
But let no crisis go unused.
And yeah, thank you, Rahm Emanuel. And now, going into the fall, you're predicting what's going to happen 3 months from now? Now, listen, LA County Director of Public Health, Dr. Barbara Ferrer, was in another conference call yesterday.